and prevented the exacerbation of a bad situation. This has helped to identify the products, the potential properties, and has promoted the credibility and international acceptance of pharmaceutical products developed here in Nigeria. NIPRID, our host, has also developed an impressive variety of pharmaceutical products from indigenous resources, and both the NIPRIMUNE and the NIPRIMUNE Plus, both of which I have the pleasure of seeing, have been found to possess reasonable properties that are able to prevent or work against COVID-19. Both products, which have been registered by NAFDAC, are currently undergoing various levels of clinical studies towards approval for production for emergency use. The NIPRID DG, Dr. Adigwe, has assured me that by this time next year, the Institute will launch three new products currently under development, that is nanomedicine, artificial intelligence, and machine learning centers. It is this proactive approach that we must take to the slow pace of vaccine access in Africa, and of course Nigeria. Although we receive from help from friendly nations and the COVAX Alliance, less than 4% of our eligible population will have been vaccinated by the end of this year. There's no question that we cannot afford not to have our own vaccine production facilities. Think what would have happened to India, which has reported the most number of infections in the world after the United States, if it did not have the capacity to produce its own vaccines. Where would its 1.3 billion people find the vaccines in the emergency that they faced? Today, India has given at least one dose to 65% of its 944 million eligible adults, and the necessary two doses to 22%. They expect overall domestic vaccine production to exceed 1 billion doses by the end of the year, which would of course be more than enough for their domestic needs. Nigeria, and I know that Professor Tomari is very well aware of this, is in talks with the World Bank on the private lending arm and other lenders to raise about 30 million to help finance a vaccine plan. BioVaccines Nigeria Limited, chaired by Professor Tomori, 49% of the company is owned by the Nigerian government, but the balance held by May and Baker Nigeria PLC. And they have plans to begin construction of a plant, I believe in the first quarter of next year. The plant, which is supposed to be located in Otta, in Ogun State, will initially, we're told, fail and finish, which I'm also told means importing the raw materials for the vaccines and then packaging it for distribution. Some South African companies are already involved in doing exactly that. I believe Aspen PharmaCare and BioVac Institute operate similar facilities. Full manufacturing, we're told, is expected to follow in the coming months or years. I'm not entirely certain when. So it's evident that the way forward is more funding for healthcare and research, for innovators, and to develop solutions in pharmaceuticals and medical consumables. And I want to say that after some of the discussion that I held with Dr. Adigwe about what to do and how to go about this, I think that I'm more than inspired, you know, especially regarding not just the potential, but exactly how the how-to of getting the kinds of support that the pharmaceutical industry and especially our research agencies would require.